wrestling. Professional wrestling the way it used to be and the way you like it. Hi, wrestling fans. I'm Bob Cuddle, along with Dr. Dutch Mantel. And Dutch, I got that right this time. Hey, we got a great hour in store for all you wrestling fans. The Thrill Seekers, they're going to be making their debut right here live this week on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Hey, April 1st is drawing closer every day, Dutch, and the Heavenly Bodies or the Rock and Roll. One of those two teams will be leaving Smoky Mountain Wrestling after the Bluegrass Brawl. Also, fans, this week our TV main event, it's going to be a ladder match where we've got Tracy Smothers against Chris Candido. Now, what about Down and Dirty, Dutch?
Okay, my special guest today on Down and Dirty, the first lady of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, Tammy Fitz with Prime Time, Brian Lee, will be my special guest. But now let's talk about Beat the Champ contest. I always draw the name of champion, Killer Kyle, and today...
Dutch, hey, you amaze me there, guy.
The name I draw right now to face Killer Kyle right there, what's that say?
Mike Furniss.
Mike Furniss facing Killer Kyle today. Fans, don't go away, a hot show today.
All right, right now, let's go to the ring, fans.
This is the first match on this hour of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Introducing first, at a weight of 245 pounds from Chattanooga, Tennessee, Larry Santo. And his opponent, weighing 228 pounds from Ashland, Kentucky, Bobby Blaze.
Okay, Bob, our first match here today, you know, the Winter Olympics has just been concluded a couple of weeks ago, and I think I would be remiss if I didn't, rate some of the wrestlers in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Right now, we see Bobby Blaze sending Larry Santos high into the air, a big hip toss, taking Santos down. Santos, wait a minute, I want to rate this right there. Put the camera
what
on there.
What is that? What do you got
put
out of the ring?
No, I'm going to rate Blaze's move right here. Can we get a camera on this?
All right, what'd you rate him?
Well, you'll see. When it comes up, you'll see. Look at that. 2.3 on that move. That's Olympic standards. Right now, Bobby Blaze moving in on Santos. Can't get the kill.
Good well, he move. Had him covered, Dutch, but he couldn't hold it
good
in
move.
Here now.
Good move by Larry Santos.
Hey, you know, it's great to see Commissioner Bob Armstrong. I saw him earlier. He's back in the commissioner's chair of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. And Dutch, he's got the power to wrestle now when he feels the need, in addition to his executive position. And it's been announced, Dutch, that Jim Cornette is going to face Bob Armstrong in the Bluegrass Brawl on April 1st in Pikeville in a handicap match, whatever that means.
Yeah,
Cornette's
going to
bring, well, he's going to bring a mystery partner.
Absolutely.
And we'll hear more about that, I'm sure, later.
Absolutely. That's 615-581-1233, extension 2021.
All right, Dutch, and we're going to be talking to
Commissioner Bob Armstrong
right after this match.
Wait a minute, I want to rate that move by Santos. Now, Santos, I think, is dominating this match on Blaze. Put the camera. See if the camera can come on this score that I give Larry Santos. It'll come up here in a minute.
Well, Santos is feeling pretty good about himself, Dutch.
8.6.
Great.
The Winter Olympics should have had me there.
No way. All right, here's Blaze to the corner now. Reverses that whip all the way across the ring. Goes Santos. Blaze right into the corner. He just splashed him up against the turnbuckles when they got to the corner. Blaze comes back again, but he misses it.
Good
Santos got out of the way just in the nick of time.
I'm going to have to rate. Don't even put the camera on this. 9.6 on that move by Santos.
He was going to suplex him. Blaze blocked it.
Wait a minute. Better to better suplex with the bridge. He gets the win.
Well, it's up.
Bobby Blaze right here in opening match here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. A big win over Larry Santos. Even though I outscored him, he still got the win over Larry Santos here in the opening match. Let's take a look at it. For you little Muskins at home, we see Larry Santos slide down, try to suplex Bobby Blaze. Bobby Blaze blocks him, gets under the bridge, and watch this move, a textbook suplex. Belly-to-belly with the bridge. Referee Mark Curtis sliding in. 1, 2, 3. Big win for Bobby Blaze. Let's go right now to Bob Cuddle standing by with Commissioner Bob Armstrong.
Well, Dutch, you're right. 100% right. And again, Commissioner of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, Commissioner Bob Armstrong. Let me say, I know all the fans are glad to have you back. And we're glad to have you back.
Well, it's good to be back. And, you know, I got some important announcement here. Everybody's talking about the big cage match, lose or leave in Pikeville on April 1st. Yeah. But you know, I couldn't sit back. One of these teams is going to leave. Now I've got contracts signed for the rest of the month of April. So what I've done is I've appointed alternate teams. Should the Rock and Roll Express lose, then their alternate team will be the Thrill Seekers, and they'll fill the rest of their contracts. Should the Heavenly Bodies lose, their alternate team will fill the rest of the contracts, will be Brian Lee and Chris Candido. So it's going to be a big day. It's April Fool's Day, and who knows who's going to come out on top.
Well, one of those teams definitely going to lose. That's right. Huh?
Somebody's going to lose, and somebody's going to leave. One thing I want to tell you about, though, Bob, I'm personally involved there in Pikeville on April the 1st. I've got to wrestle Jimmy Cornette and his mystery man. I've done everything I can to find out who the mystery man is. Nobody knows. The board of directors doesn't know. Nobody knows who the mystery man is. He brought in Terry Funk. We took care of him. He brought in Captain Red Dick Murdoch. We took care of him. And now he's got the mystery man. Well, I just want to tell Jim Cornette this. I'm not afraid of whoever you bring in, because in a handicap match, I have to wrestle two men. One of those times, I'm going to get my hands around his throat, and I'm going to squeeze him so hard, both of his ears may fly off. And wouldn't it be fun in Pikeville on April Fool's Day to wave bye-bye to four fools, both of the Heavenly Bodies, Jimmy Cornette and his mystery man? I wouldn't miss it for the world. I'll be there with bells on, Bob.
All right, and we will, too. Commissioner Bob Armstrong, thank you so much. Fans, we're going to be back. We'll have more action right after we take this time out. Well, fans, last week a shocking incident took place between Tammy Fitch and the Dirty White Girl. It began when White Girl was at our desk and she was doing some color commentary. Let's go back. Let's take a look at what happened last week here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Watch it, fans.
We got like two cats going at it, Dutch.
Whoa, wait a minute, and Lee has grabbed her. Primetime Brian Lee. And
wait a minute, we got some activity going on here.
Wait a minute,
they
right off of her.
Tammy Fitch, they have ripped their blouse off, and here comes a white boy.
Oh, wait a minute, here, put this coat on. Put this coat around you. My heavens alive, they ripped their clothes right off of her. Whoa, day in the morning, fans. Hey, all right, fans, right now with us at ringside, the Dirty White Girl, the Dirty White Boy. White Boy, you saw what happened last week to her. They tried to rip her clothes off of her, ripped her blouse. What do you say about that?
You know, everybody in Smoky Mountain Wrestling is getting a little sick and tired of Tammy Fitch running around embarrassing and humiliating people. Oh, she thinks it's funny. She thinks it's whoop-dee-doo. She see out with the white girl's blouse. Well, darling, I went a little step further. I talked to the new commissioner, Mr. Bob Armstrong, and I asked him for April the 1st at the Bluegrass Brawl for a particular type of match. It's not just a regular mixed tag match, but it's a back alley brawl match. And what that means is pinfalls don't count. The only way that you can win this particular type of match is you've got to strip both your opponents down to the BVD. That means standing there in your fruit-a-loom running around. It's about time, Tammy, that somebody put a little humiliation on you for a change. And there's nothing you can do about it come April the 1st, white girl.
You know, sweetie, you're fixing to pay a lot of dues because you're nothing but a rat that bounces around from motel to motel looking for some meat to get a hold of. Well, I tell you what, it's fixing to come to a screeching halt, because when I get my hands on you, not only am I going to rip your damn clothes off, sweetie, I'm going to tear your head, your damn hair and everything else completely off your skull.
Well, there you have it. You get ready in case you missed the date. It's April the 1st, Bluegrass Brawl, prime time. You and little Tammy, get ready to get humiliated. Let's rock and roll.
All right, right now, let's go to the ring, fans.
This match is for the Beat the Champ TV title. Introducing first, the champion, at weight of 305 pounds from Hell's Kitchen, New York, Killer Kyle.
Killer Kyle. Now you see Mike Furness running around the ring like he run around Neyland Stadium in Knoxville all those years. Never got into a game anyway. Just run him down the sideline.
Well, from the University of Tennessee, you know, last week we saw Kyle win the Beat the Champ title.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing his opponent at weight of 246 pounds from the University of Tennessee, Mike Furness.
Oh, wait a minute.
All right, and Hey, Dutch, you know, Furnace is still attending the Smoky Mountain Wrestling School.
Well, he still should be buying a ticket, if you ask me. Well, he should even be in the ring with Killer Kyle. Here's a man who's trying to push him past his potential, and all they're going to do, Smoky Mountain, is going to get him hurt.
Well, he's a great athlete.
Well, I'm not saying that.
Great athlete, Dutch, and he wanted another career from football to professional wrestling.
Well,
and I think he has all of the tools that he's going to be a tremendous professional wrestler. But he's in there against a tough one now in Killer Kyle from Hell's Kitchen, New York. Kyle knows how to hurt you. He can hurt you in a number of different ways. Hit him covered a count of two. Boy, Furnace just did kick out of that.
Well, first of all, like you say, he wants another career. So do I. I want all kind of different careers, but I'm not going to step in the ring with a guy over 300 pounds trying to make my career without a lot of experience. Oh, he played football. Football's a lot different than professional wrestling. You know that.
Bob, no doubt about
it. I know
it.
You're not an athlete, but I am. But that's a big, big...
101, and Kyle missed that elbow.
Wait a minute.
Well, you don't have a team behind you. Look at Furnace now. He's getting down in that football block position. And he came with that forearm blow.
He didn't level him, though. He didn't level him.
Another one now, Kyle, down to a knee.
He didn't.
Hard to get down to the mat.
Well, you see right now.
Headbutt now by Kyle.
The inexperience is showing on Furnace because he's a little bit wary. Oh!
And that block did it. Boy, that took him off his feet.
One, two, wait a minute.
What a shocker.
He's got a new champ.
What a shocker. Mike Furnace wins his first title in Smoky Mountain.
Lucky. Lucky.
Only a few matches under his belt, Dutch, and he did it.
Take a look at the slow-mo right here. If we can run it back right now, we see Mike Furnace. He's only had about a half dozen matches. A big shoulder tackle. Well, he can do that good. Johnny Majors taught him well at the University of Tennessee, and he is smart. He rolls in right to the pin. Mark Curtis, 1, 2, 3. New TV champion. Let's see if we can get a word with Mike Furnace. Let's go to Bob Caudill standing by with Mike Furnace right now.
All right, right you are, Dutch, and what a great win for this young man. The first championship in Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
I'm humbled by the whole situation here. I can't believe it's a title match. It's my first one. I got to humble myself with this, and it's unbelievable. I don't even know what went on.
Well, I don't know what happened. Maybe a lot of luck figured into it. I don't know. But he's a great athlete, fans. That may just be one of many championships for Mike Furnace. We'll be back. Right now, let's take this time out. Hey, Dutch, you know the match is set. April 1st, the Bluegrass Brawl, the longest and most celebrated tag team feud in wrestling, will come to an end, maybe forever, because it's the Rock and Roll Express against the Heavenly Bodies inside a steel cage for the title. The losers must leave Smoky Mountain Wrestling. The Bodies got a leg up in a recent marathon match after over 55 minutes. The falls were tied, and here's what happened. Fans, let's go back and watch it.
Wrestling fans, we've got 3 minutes remaining in this match. There is a small package. Del Rey comes in for the save. Hi, this is Phil Rainey, and we're in the marathon match with less than 3 minutes remaining. It's all tied up at two falls apiece in this match. And this is Robert Gibson working against Gigolo Jimmy Del Rey. And across the way, Ricky Morton shoots Tom Pritchard across the ring. And it's a sleeper. Where's Cornette? Cornette just left the ring, ladies and gentlemen. Where'd he go? He normally is ringside in a crucial match like this with a tennis racket, but he is nowhere to be seen. Last time I saw him, as we saw him leave the ring, he was heading toward the dressing room. It's not like Cornette to do that. The Rock and Roll Express took the first fall in this match and then went 25 minutes before the Heavenly Bodies picked up their fall in the match, and it was all tied up at 1-1 there. Now it's 2-2, and Ricky Morton still has that sleeper on Tom Pritchard. Mark Curtis, small package behind in the two count, and it's Robert Gibson kicking out. Ricky Morton still has a sleeper on Tom Pritchard. Referee Mark Curtis, a little bit worse for wear in this match as he's gone off 55 minutes in a grueling match. Ricky Morton shoots Tom Pritchard into that turnbuckle. And here goes Robert Gibson trying to roll up Jimmy Del Rey, and he gets a two count. Cornette has still not come back to this match, wrestling fans. Mark Curtis lifts Tom Pritchard's arm for the second time, gets a two count. And where is Cornette? It looks like all of the wrestlers in this ring, along with the referee themselves, are just completely exhausted. This has been a grueling match for 57, 58 minutes it's been going now. It's still knotted up at two falls apiece in this match. Tom Pritchard, again, having his arm raised for the second time, puts the foot on the rope. Cornette has still not made an appearance. And we've got less than 2 minutes remaining in this match. And once again, well, I said 2 minutes, actually 1 minute remaining, looking at the stopwatch here. And with time running out, I don't believe the Heavenly Bodies are going to be able to, well, the Rock and Roll Express is going to be able to pull this match off here with two falls apiece. Cornette's got, what is that in his hand? He's putting something on Tom Pritchard's face. It's an oxygen bottle, wrestling fans. He's putting a mask on the face of Tom Pritchard, giving him that second shot of adrenaline there, and Pritchard comes right back. He's getting that second or third win in this match. And here goes backdrop with Ricky Morton sending Tom Pritchard to the canvas. Cornette caught him with the bottle, and here is the hook, the leg, and what happens here? There is the three count as the Heavenly Bodies take the third fall in this exciting match here at the Knoxville Coliseum. And we've got less than 15 seconds remaining now. I don't believe the Rock and Roll Express is going to pull this out. Once again, it's 3-2 with Cornette using that oxygen bottle to put it in the stomach of Ricky Morton. And we've got what? And it's, there is the roll up and the two count and the bell rings. We don't get a three count on this. It looks like the Heavenly Bodies once again retain their Smoky Mountain Tag Team Championship.
Rock and Roll Express, we proved one more time we're not only in better shape, we can go an hour and not even feel it, but also that we're the better tag team because we beat you 3-2 in the marathon match. And the same thing's going to happen at the Bluegrass Brawl April the 1st inside the steel cage, Morton and Gibson. Loser of the match leaves Smoky Mountain Wrestling. And finally, after 10 long years, that's it, boys, you're in the best shape of your life. After 10 long years, I'm going to rid myself and the world of my worst nemesis. The Heavenly Bodies are going to beat the Rock and Roll Express, and the Rock and Roll Express will be the ones at the Greyhound bus station on Saturday morning, April the 2nd. Come on, boys, you're in great shape.
All right, and fans, here they are, the Rock and Roll Express. Rick, that was a long, long match.
Well, Bob, everybody just seen a prime example of how Jimmy Cornette comes down to save his Heavenly Bodies. But you got to understand one thing. Coming up April the 1st at Bluegrass Brawl, we're going to have a match inside a steel cage. Loser leaves Smoky Mountain Wrestling, and the titles are on the line. You know, I got to say one thing about Jimmy Cornette. His Heavenly Bodies, this is the toughest team that he's ever managed. But without your help, Jimmy Cornette, the Heavenly Bodies aren't too much. But you see, because we're inside a steel cage, that means only go in the steel door. You can't go out. That means, Jimmy Cornette, you can't interfere.
Yeah.
You see, the only way to get back at Jimmy Cornette is take away something that he loves. And you know he loves his Heavenly Bodies in more than one way. Everybody knows that. So you see, Jimmy Cornette, Pikeville, Kentucky, Bluegrass Brawl, you remember one thing. This is our last go around for the Rock and Roll Express, and we're not planning on losing, because like I told you many times before, rock and roll, we're here to stay. We're not here to play. Thank you.
All right, guys, April 1st, Pikeville, Kentucky, the Bluegrass Brawl, that's it. We're gonna be back. We're gonna have more action. And we're going to hear from Dutch Mantel and Down and Dirty right after this.
Smoky Mountain Wrestling presents the Bluegrass Brawl 2, the famous final scene, Friday, April 1st at the Pikeville College Gym in Pikeville, Kentucky. The main event for the tag title inside a steel cage. It's Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies battling the Rock and Roll Express, and the losing team must leave Smoky Mountain Wrestling. The Dirty White Boy and Dirty White Girl battle Brian Lee and Tammy Fitch in a back alley brawl. The only way to win is to tear the other team's clothes off. In a handicap match, Bullet Bob Armstrong faces Jim Cornette and his mystery partner. Tracy Smothers faces Chris Candido in the $2,500 ladder match. The first man to climb the ladder and grab the $2,500 hanging over the ring wins the match and the money. You'll see the debut of the Thrill Seekers, Lance Storm and Chris Jericho in Pikeville, as they face the team of Well Done. Gold Circle ticket holders admitted at 6 p.m. for a party with the stars. Meet the Rock and Roll, White Boy and White Girl, Tracy, Bullet, Bob, and the Thrill Seekers in person. Get free autographs and free food and drink courtesy of Papa John's Pizza of Pikeville. Gold Circle tickets only $15 for dinner, drinks, party with the stars, and seats in the first three rows. Other ticket prices ringside $8, general admission $6, and kids $5. Tickets on sale at Trans Financial Bank, Pikeville National Bank, Bank One of Pikeville, Family Federal Savings, and Mate One National Bank. Remember last year's sellout and get your tickets early for the Bluegrass Brawl 2, the famous final scene. Friday, April 1st at Pikeville College Gym.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Down and Dirty with Dutch. I'm Dr. Dutch Mantel. This is the most popular segment on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Right now, my special guest, and I have to say, it is a pleasure to welcome the First Lady of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, Tammy Fitch, and Primetime Brian Lee. A lot of things going on in your life, Tammy, and I'm sure you'd like to share it with the fans of Smoky Mountain right now.
We have a match coming up at the Bluegrass Brawl on April 1st. It's going to be a mixed tag team match with Brian and myself looking across the ring at the Dirty White Boy and the Dirty White Girl. Now wait, this isn't a normal match. This is a strip the clothes match. The winner can't win by pinfall. You can't win by submission. You can't win by having the other person get counted out. The loser will get their clothes completely stripped from their body. Not one of us, but two. The entire team. And let me tell you something. This is going to be on April Fool's Day, and we're not the fools that are going to get stripped. I don't care what we have to do, but the Dirty White Boy and the Dirty White Girl are losing their clothes. There's no doubt about it. But you know what I was just thinking? All you got to do is toss a $10 bill over the Dirty White Girl. She'll take her clothes off for you right there. There's no doubt about it. And you know, I wonder what she can do for $20. What do you think, Dutch?
Well, I agree wholeheartedly with you. That's what you say, Miss Fitz.
Exactly. You know.
Wait a minute. I'm out of this. I'm in the corner. It looks like we got company. The Dirty White Girl is coming in the ring, obviously upset. Tammy Fitz says she's going to strip it right here. We got more company. Watch out, Prime Time. Watch out, Prime Time. Look out. Look out. Prime Time. You got company. Dirty White Boy standing right behind you. Thrill Seekers making their debut next here on Smoky Mountain.
All right, fans, right back with us here is, of course, Jim Cornette. Jim, we had the pleasure earlier of welcoming Bob Armstrong back as Commissioner of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. And he says, hey, Jim Cornette's going to have a mystery partner I got to take care of.
Oh, you welcome Bob Armstrong. Yeah, I guess you welcome the tax man when he comes to your house. I guess you welcome people when they come to break in and steal something. That's the kind of guy Bob Armstrong is. Let me say, first of all, everybody saw a little earlier in this program that the Rock and Roll Express cannot take the Heavenly Bodies. We beat them once again, and we did it fair and square and legal. And at April 1st at the Bluegrass Brawl, brother, Rock and Roll, you know, Ricky Morton said, they're going to take their boots and their tights off. They're going to throw them in a pile in the middle of the ring, and they'll never wrestle again if they lose that match. Well, I got news for you. I'm bringing me a can of gasoline, and we're going to have a little bonfire. We're going to burn those raggedy tights. We're going to burn those stinking boots, because rock and roll, after 10 long years, this thing between me and you is coming to a halt, and it's going to happen at the Bluegrass Brawl on April the 1st. The Bodies will beat you, and you'll not only be out of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, but if you live up to your word, you'll be out of wrestling entirely. And then, Bob Armstrong, my other problem. I know he thought he had this thing handled, but I still got one more trick up my sleeve. You see where I've made my mistake in the past? I've told Bob Armstrong exactly what was going to happen. I've told him who he was going to face. I brought in Terry Funk and Dick Murdoch, Dory Funk Jr., all the top stars in wrestling, but I told him ahead of time who he was going to have to wrestle. Well, this time, Bob Armstrong, I realized, because even though you're a no-good stinking redneck, just like all the rest of these people, you are tough, I'll give you that. So I got to do a little thinking of my own. You don't know, Bob Armstrong, who you're going to wrestle. You don't know who's going to be my partner at the Bluegrass Brawl. It may be a WWF star, maybe even Yokozuna. Or it may be an international star like Abdullah the Butcher or Kevin Sullivan. Or it may be somebody that's not even involved in professional wrestling. And Bob Armstrong, believe me, I'm the only one that knows this man is coming. And you're not going to know it until it's too late. Because by the time that you find out, believe me, he's going to be on top of you, and you ain't never going to get out from underneath him. April the 1st at the Bluegrass Brawl, we're going to get rid of the Rock and Roll Express, and I'm going to solve my Bob Armstrong problem once and for all. Armstrong, nobody knows who this guy is, and you won't until it's too late.
All right, fans, April 1st, Pikeville, Kentucky. It's all going to come down then. Let's go to the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a tag team match. Introducing first at a weight of 450 pounds, Fire and Brimstone, the Infernos. Gentlemen, introducing, making their debut here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling at a total combined weight of 468 pounds from Canada, Lance Storm and Chris Jericho, the Thrill Seekers!
Chris Storm and Chris Jericho and Lance Storm making their debut appearance here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. We've heard a lot about them. This is their debut appearance here on television, so fans get a good look at them. This team probably considered the team of the 90s. Well, a lot of big, exciting things expected out of them.
Dutch, I don't think anybody's ever stirred up as much anticipation as Smoky Mountain Wrestling. This is supposedly one of the finest tag team combinations to come along in years, and we're looking forward to really having them around Smoky Mountain Wrestling. This is Lance Storm. He's the short, dark-haired one. By that I mean short hair.
Good move. Excellent move by Storm. And a big dive off that middle rope. You don't see that much in American wrestling. But it was a move executed very well. Now I'm going to give these guys a shout out with that.
How he got in the air. Hey, he must have been about 10 feet above the ring. Dutch, we had some money up there on that. On that line that they were going to have to take a ladder to, he knocked it down when he got up with that dropkick. That's how high he got. Okay. You know, they're former Canadian tag champions. They relinquished the belts to come to the USA. And as you heard Bob Armstrong say, if the Rock and Roll lose in Pikeville, then these Thrill Seekers, they're going to be assuming their bookings. Here is Chris Jericho. You saw that move. He went across the ropes, across the turnbuckles, right onto the apron of the ring.
A lot of energy this team has. They're called the Thrill Seekers with a lot of energy, and from what I've seen thus far, a lot of talent. They're going to have it. They're going to stay competitive in Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Well, high in the air with a suplex. Yeah, you know, Dutch, you don't see moves like this. I don't think I've ever seen moves like this in American wrestling.
No, that move he used previously when he hit the second rope and come off of the crossbody block, you don't see a lot of American wrestlers using those moves. And since you don't see a lot of American wrestlers using them, you see American wrestlers being surprised by a double leapfrog, double clothesline, good tag team combination work by the Thrill Seekers.
Only two, and you saw the Inferno kick out of it. You know, we talked about that. Some of the most thrilling moves that you ever see, Dutch. They're real daredevils in the ring, these two.
Matt Storm with one of those whip suplexes. They come over, referee Mark Curtis.
Only a count of two again.
Almost got the pin on the Infernos. Fire and Brimstone is what they call themselves.
Well, they're in against a couple of wild ones right now. These two guys go at it. Dutch, they don't slow down. The pace is tremendous, and they keep this pace up during the entire match. They tag a lot. They switch. They keep the fresh man in the ring. And as you say, they have really got the move.
Good counter move by Chris Jericho. Inferno had the presence of mind to duck under one clothesline. Jericho came back and nailed him with the second one.
Another tag. We're going to get another switch. Hey, we got a very high-risk move here. Both of them on the top rope. They come off. Double drop kick.
Booming drop kick. Reminiscent of another team, maybe.
On the button, guys.
They come off the top, and their debut match here won by the Thrill Seekers, Lance Storm and Chris Jericho. Fans, let's stand by for a slow-mo replay of what happened here. The Thrill Seekers, of course, taking the area by storm. And I'm going to have to give those boys a 9.95 on that match. Hey, I call it right down the middle right there. An excellent win by the Thrill Seekers. Okay, let's take a look at it. See both of them on the top rope. There's Lance and Jericho firing brimstone. And does he take it right on the button? And they take him right down. And I don't believe nobody's going to get up off that one. Referee Mark Curtis, 1, 2, 3. An excellent, excellent win here by the Thrill Seekers. Let's see if we can get a word with them. Let's go right now to Bob Caldwell standing by with Lance Storm and Chris Jericho, the Thrill Seekers.
All right, right you are, Dutch. We're here with the Thrill Seekers, and of course, you just saw them. What a great, great debut here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling for Lance Storm and Chris Jericho. Lance?
Well, I tell you, I hope the people of Smoky Mountain Wrestling are ready, because the Thrill Seekers are here. We got our first taste of Smoky Mountain action, and we're loving it. And we're ready for more. I hope you can handle it, because the Thrill Seekers are here.
I tell you, you guys got some tremendous moves in there, and the fans love them, every one.
Thank you very much, Bob Caudill. And that was only the tip of the iceberg. Right here, the Thrill Seekers in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. And we are so happy to be here. We just can't believe it. We haven't been able to sleep. We haven't been able to eat. But now it's started, and everybody here knows it. And they want to see the Thrill Seekers. And I know everyone has their seat, because we're coming, baby, right on.
All right, high energy fans from the Thrill Seekers. We're going to be back right after this.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a ladder match for $2,500. Introducing first, at a weight of 224 and a quarter pounds from Asbury Park, New Jersey, the Suicide Blonde, Chris Candido.
Well, a big roar goes up from the crowd here in Dungannon, Virginia.
Yes, sir.
Looking at this crowd here a little bit, Bob. It looks like the people that have been checking from the river, they all made their way to Duncan to the Thrill Seekers, Doug. Obviously.
Yeah, there's
really the train.
Now, here we see the
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing at a weight of 236 pounds from Springfield, Tennessee, the wild-eyed Southern boy, Tracy Smothers.
All right, and Dutch, there you can see on that line over the ring, that envelope up there containing $2,500. There it is. And there's the ladder outside the ring. And there's the envelope with the $2,500. The object is, somebody's got to go out of the ring, get that ladder, set it up in the ring, climb it, get up there, and get that $2,500 that's suspended from the ring. Now, you know, these two men, they're going to meet in another ladder match at the Bluegrass Brawl if no one breaks their neck in this one, Dutch, and they very well could.
Yeah, a lot of people talking about the Bluegrass Brawl, April the 1st in Pikeville, Kentucky. These two men, some are two main participants in that card coming up there, and it's going to be a big kick by Smothers. And he levels Chris Candido right off the bat. Now, I'm going to say a few things about what's happened today on television, but we see Smothers go out of the ring trying to get the ladder.
He came for the ladder.
And here comes Candido trying to, and using the ladder
as a
battering ram. Now, all he's got to do is set that ladder up in the middle of the ring, but he's got one major obstacle in his way, and that is Chris Candido.
That is a major one, no doubt about it. And Dutch, these two men, they bounce that money back and forth and side bets on TV and in matches around the area, just adding to the bad feelings that existed between them. And there's some bad blood between these two guys, and it's been there for many, many, many months. By the way, while these two go at it in the corner, Dutch, let me remind all our fans in Smoky Mountain Wrestling for a personal appearance from a Smoky Mountain Wrestling star, call Pam Lawson at 615-587-1273. Now the Dirty White Boy and the Dirty White Girl will be appearing April 1st at the Papa John's Pizza in Pikeville from 3 to 5.
Man, all right, Ken, while you were that. Talking, they were some heavy
blows it out, weren't they?
Being exchanged between Candido and Tracy Smothers. Over the top, a one-legged kick, almost like a drop kick, except he only put one leg up. Candido only...
Dutch, you know, it's dangerous. Oh. That ladder is still inside that ring, and that's a very dangerous object. Fans, you see it there. Somebody can get hurt and get hurt seriously with that ladder. Now, here comes Tracy Smothers. He's going to set it up. He's going to make an effort to go for the money. He kicks Candido by sliding underneath that bottom rope, Dutch, knocked him right off of the apron, back down to the floor. He's going to go at it.
Well, he's almost got it, but Candido, a low bridge by the Suicide Blonde, and he hammers Smothers down on the mat. You know, the Bluegrass Brawl, April the 1st in Pikeville, a big, big event in wrestling, not only in Smoky Mountain, but all over in the wrestling world.
Let me ask you about that.
People talking
about
it.
What about that match between the Dirty White Boy and the Dirty White Girl announced earlier today at the Bluegrass Brawl? They're going to take on Tammy Fitch and primetime Brian Lee in a back alley brawl.
Well,
here went that ladder.
I'm going to say, if you don't want to see naked people, I'd say stay home that night, because somebody's going to get stripped naked. Now, you see right now,
He's got it in over the head of Candido, and this is why we talked about how dangerous that could be, Doug.
He's got the centrifuge going a little bit, but at this point right now,
he rammed him right into the post.
But now,
Candido, with that ladder, he had his head up between two rungs of it.
I am talking, Bob, and he gets hammered with the ladder right in the head. Now, these two men are really hammering each other right now, going to it tooth and nail. But as long as that ladder was around Candido's neck, that actually meant that Smothers cannot use it. So obviously it looked like an offensive move, but actually it was both.
Well, it could be a very deadly move, because Candido could get his head cut off or his neck broken.
And I want to say,
that thing over his head.
On my Down and Dirty segment, when the Dirty White Girl came in, she was trying to do a Tonya Harding. She's the Tonya Harding of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Come in and try to sucker somebody from the back, and I think she ought to be fine. Bob Armstrong should do his job. If he's going to be commissioner, I think he ought to go ahead and fine her and suspend her from Smoky Mountain Wrestling for her actions during Down and Dirty. What do you think about that, Bob?
I don't think so.
Here goes.
I don't agree with you on that. Well, here goes Smothers again.
You don't have to agree
with me. He's setting that ladder up again. He's going to make an effort to get that $2,500.
Candido.
Here goes up the ladder. Here comes Candido. And he was just a little slow, Dutch. He only liked an inch or two, and he would have had it. At least he would have had that envelope out from under that pin on that rope. And now down in the corner, Smothers, with Candido's foot right across his throat as he had his head on that bottom rope. Candido going to use the ladder and just slams Tracy's mother's hard in that ladder. Let's see if Candido now is going to make an effort. No, he's going to use it as a battering ram. Watch out, Smothers, there it comes. Dutch.
Well, these men.
This is dangerous. This is something to watch.
Well, Bob, what do you think this is supposed to be?
Yeah, but
locker room?
You don't want to see anybody lose a limb or get put out of professional wrestling forever, lose a career over
$2,500. Well, let me tell you, Bob, when these guys go into the ring, I don't care if it's Smoky Mountain or anywhere, when you go into the ring in the professional wrestling business, you can expect injuries, and you can expect almost any match could be career ending. Actually, you could end your own career by blowing your knee out. A lot of things could happen. But we see right now Candido leveling Tracy Smothers right now with a beautiful, beautiful suplex. I need to rate that one.
How would you rate
that move. Throw it up there. That's a great move.
All right, and how would you rate that?
9.95. I just wrote it down, and the camera come in. Great move by
He's
Chris
gonna go
Candido.
At it again, and that time it was blocked by the Wildlife Belly to belly that time from Tracy Smothers. Hey, Dutch, who can this mystery partner be that Cornette's bringing to face Bob Armstrong?
Well,
it could be a WWF star. It could be an international star. Cornette said it could be even somebody from outside of wrestling.
Yeah,
I don't know whether he means like a boxer or a heavyweight boxing champion or who he might bring in.
Could be karate guy.
Yeah.
Judo guy.
Yeah.
Could be anybody. Baseball player, Michael Jordan. Could be a lot of people.
Under the ladder.
Did he
and
slam?
And Smothers slammed to it.
Okay, Candido noted for his aerial.
Somebody, very, very high risk maneuver right here, and this could be extremely dangerous because it's Candido who hits that ladder right on his knee, Dutch, That's what we talked about. You can blow a knee out like that.
First of all, I have to question the rationale and the sanity of that move. Now, I've said time and time again, sometimes windows of opportunity have to open in a match, and you have to get right on it. Candido, he went to that window just a little too late. He gave Smothers time to recover, and right now, not only did he miss Smothers, he landed on the ladder, and now Smothers got a second win.
And Tracy Smothers is irate. And he is really upset, Dutch. Watch him. He's going to try to take all of his anger and all of his feelings out on Candido now. Into the corner, up over Candido. This could be punishment. Punishment time for Candido.
One, two, a left.
Hey,
right,
you can count.
Left, right.
Being a doctor, I guess you could count.
Yes,
that.
I can count. I'm a mathematics major, too. There's not a lot I can't do. And a backspinning heel kick. His head knocked his head right into the ladder. And it looks like Candido is in some serious, serious trouble right here.
And we mentioned all along with that ladder
off the top,
how extremely dangerous it is. Here comes Smothers.
The double axe handle.
And he caught him right high on the head with it. And now Candido to the mat. I don't know whether Smothers is going to try to punish him more, going to try to get that money. He's not going to go to the ladder.
Well,
to the top ropes again, Dutch.
Well, I think what
he's... here he comes.
A shoulder block off the top. Now he's got really Candido exactly where he wants him. He's got him neutralized, so to speak. And there goes the ladder right up in the middle of the ring.
He's going to make another attempt for the envelope and the $2,500. They're both going up. They're both going up. Candido one side, Smothers the other. Candido up on top. They're fighting on the ladder. Can you believe that? About 8 feet above the ring.
Wait a minute.
They aren't going to suplex him from there, to be sure.
He's trying to suplex him off the ladder.
And there goes Candido.
Oh!
Face first.
Wait a minute. And it looks like Smothers got the money. We got a winner. We got a winner. Tracy Smothers, the winner here. And the ladder match referee, Mark Curtis, holding his hand up. Candido upset. Wait a minute. He's attacking Smothers.
Yeah, he got it from behind. And he grabbed the envelope with the money. Candido got it, stomping down Smothers as he had Smothers down. Goes back to get the ladder, folds it up. He's going to use the ladder again as the weapon. Just slams it down on Tracy Smothers.
Well, Smothers has won
it. Smothers had the money.
But he has not won the war.
He's going to lose this war, it looks like, Dutch.
And remember, fans, these two guys going at it again. Bluegrass Brawl for the first and five bill as we see Candido stomping that industrial ladder there. And he's... Okay, fans, we got to go. We got to go.
All right, we'll be back right after this. All right, fans, with us right now, here's the wild-eyed Southern boy, Tracy Smothers, one of the most dangerous matches we've seen in a long time. We've checked with the commissioner, Smoky Mountain officials. You are going to get that money back.
Mr. Caudill, I'm not worried about that money right now. It's Chris Candido's hide that I want. Let me tell you something, Candido. All the fans in Dungannon, Virginia, and the millions of people watching this show right now saw me kick your butt, and I deserve that $2,500. But Bluegrass Brawl, Pikeville, Kentucky, that is my town. That's a very lucky town for me. We got a ladder matches coming up, and I'll guarantee you this, by the good grace of God and the support of the fans, the South is going to rise again at Pikeville April 1st. Thank you, Mr. Clark.
All right, from the Wild-Eyed Southern Boy. All right, the dirty white boy, the dirty white girl, and I know what this is right here. Hey. Kind of proud of that, aren't you?
I'm real proud. How you feeling now, primetime Brian Lee? A little embarrassed? A little humiliation going on, maybe? Where was your girl at? She looked like a greyhound dog scooting out this building and left you there, didn't she? Well, come April the 1st, Bluegrass Brawl, primetime, we got you, but I got to get you one more time. And then, after I get you all stripped down to your underwear, them drawers, then we're going to turn all of our attention on Tammy Fitch. And Tammy, by the time we get through with you, you ain't going to be wearing nothing but your birthday suit. We'll see you April the 1st, Bluegrass Brawl.
All right, fans, next week right here, the Dirty White Boy, Killer Kyle, for the championship. Also a video of the Thrill Seekers and more next week. We'll see you then. Until then, so long for now.